Hey everyone, today we're going to cover how to move from the blackout phase and get into adding key features of our car in 3D modeling. This is part of a series where I'll be covering car modeling from beginning to end. Today's video focuses specifically on the tips and workflows for adding the key elements and features of our car exterior, like the hood scoop, fender flares, front air splitter, air dam, and the headlights. This tutorial is a combination of step-by-step workflows and narrated time lapses. This series is targeted for beginner to advanced skill level in 3D modeling. Maya 2022.1 will be used for this tutorial, but the workflows can be applied to any 3D software as well as any version of Maya. So with that, let's get started. Okay, so here we are in Maya, and as you can see, I have the key features and elements on the front of the vehicle already roughed in, blocked in, modeled in. So I have the fender flares, the air dam, the air splitter going on the front. I have a simple headlights here, and then the hood scoop, the hood detail as well. So all of that is really adding to the details and the key elements on the front of the vehicle. And I'm going to walk you through the process on how I did that, okay? So as you can see, if I go ahead and grab where we left off last, which was this here, you can see actually it looks quite a bit different. So what I'm going to do is just grab where we last landed, duplicate that, and then Maya likes to break materials, so I'll just reassign a material. Whenever it turns green, it just lost its connection to the material, and I believe that's just because I had them as an instance. So I can just reapply that, and I want to go ahead and hold shift right click and apply a combine here. All right, and with that combine, I'll go ahead and just run a quick merge vertices with a really low threshold, like 0.003, something like that. And then there we go. So we have this roughed in, this block out that was created from the blueprints here, as well as the curve groups. Now, I do want to say a big thank you to Maro Sana on the YouTube channel. He went ahead and commented on my fumbling around of the curve tool, the curve snapping. So I went ahead and pinned that, so that was really helpful. It does work a little bit different than the standard tools, right? So if I go here, just so I can quickly show you what we're talking about, and I'll grab the poly surface and curve guide groups and isolate that. Now, a typical snap, you just hold like V for vertex snap and it'll automatically snap when you left click and drag, or if you middle mouse and drag. But for the curve tool, it works a little bit differently. What you have to do is hover over here, hold C for curve snap, and instead of left clicking, you can see that it doesn't actually snap there. You just hover over the curve and middle mouse, and there you go. And then it just snaps right to it. And when he's told me that, I was like, oh man, I knew I was missing something, but it's been a while since I've used the curve techniques. So it works out pretty well. As you can see, just hold in C, we'll snap it right to there. This one's being a little bit stubborn, but there you go. And you can slide along it, which is pretty nice. So I wanted to make sure to cover that one. So that fix is at least documented in this tutorial series, so you have that. And I'll go ahead and hide the curves. And what we want to do now is refine the form, okay? Because like I said, like if I go ahead and actually just give this a different material here and give this like an obvious like green, or let's just say this blue material, you can see how much different this looks from the previous main body. And it looks quite a bit different. And the reason why is because I'm breaking off of the blueprints here. All right. So the blueprints helped me block in the rough body, but you can see now the shape and that detail on my current Datsun is quite a bit different. Let me turn off smooth preview here. All right. And I definitely like the direction that it's going in now. It has more style, it has more curvature, more appeal than what it did previously. And that's the whole point of blocking it out, okay? So that's gonna be very helpful. And how did I go about that? Well, let me ahead and move this into the center. I'll go ahead and hide my current vehicle. And what I wanna do is jump to my reference here, okay? You can see that I have quite a few references here. I'm using this in my Pure Ref mood board. You can see that pretty much, you know, this is the Datsun 240Z Fair Lady, and people just mod this out all sorts of different ways. So I'm still gonna, you know, I'm still figuring out exactly what exact mods that I want or what types of fender flares and air dam splitters that I want to add. But for the most part, I can at least block in those key features and I can pick, well, do I want kind of this type of air dam, or do I want this type or that type, so on and so forth. But I'm blocking in the main features now, so that's all that matters. So I can grab really any one of those images, and then I can do that camera matching that I showed in the very first part, or the intro to how to get started, and I use that to camera match here. And once you have that, what I'll do now is actually go to display, polygons, and turn off back face calling so I can see this. So you can see that the overall form is there, but it's just a little, the proportions are a bit off from the blueprint, and blueprints.com, they have good references, but sometimes they're not perfect. So I want to base this off of the real world. So what I'll do now is take this and use what's called a lattice, okay? So if I go to deform and add a lattice here, you can see now I can start manipulating the overall shape of the vehicle without actually having to do that on a vertex by vertex basis or edge by edge basis, okay? Now I typically go in and add in a few extra elements here. So I add in, you know, these subdivisions across the line of symmetry, and then for the ones running horizontally or across the U, I go ahead and add in quite a few there, so about 5 divisions. Now, again, what this is gonna do is, now if you select the lattice, hold right click and go to lattice point, now you can start manipulating and moving these points, and it's kind of going ahead and adjusting the overall shape and form of the vehicle. So you can use this to help with the overall shape and form. And you can see I can kind of bring down the scoop, and this works way, way better than just manually going in and messing with the vertices. So like I said, what I can do now is just kind of maybe X-ray here. And what I'll do is go ahead and select these points like so. And I'll go ahead back here to my perspective camera match view, and then there we go, and we can see that this hood, or not the hood line, but this windowsill here is off by quite a bit. No problem, I can go ahead now and just kind of drag these middle points like this and just kind of move that back, and look at that, look how nicely that just adjusts the overall form on this vehicle. Okay, now it looks like the hood can come up quite a bit, and I use this for all of my large scale changes. There you go, so you can get some nice detail there. And once I do that, I'm kind of happy with how most of that is looking, and then I can go ahead and bring this down like so on the front and bring that down. And this is gonna give me some nice changes. So this is what I did to just rough in the overall shape. And you can even like bring this to kind of narrow that front end a little bit, which is what I ended up doing. And all of that is gonna really just help bring in that form. And then once you're done, you go ahead and just select the object, the poly surface here. And then I just go ahead and simply delete history. And then now you can continue to work on this. Now that I've done that, what I'll do is just kind of clean up some of these edges here. What I will do is go ahead, this is probably a little bit hard to see with the edge selection, so I'll just go ahead and apply that gray again. And what I can do is just select these middle edges like so, and I'm just gonna just control backspace and remove those, okay? And I don't need those quite yet because I just want to get this nice straight form, and then you can just use this perspective to get in and have that match as you need it, okay? And then there's this kind of little lip that's coming up, and keep in mind, I am working with symmetry here, so in the modeling toolkit, you can just make sure to enable symmetry like so. And then you can kind of bring that up, just get that nice curvature going along there. And then you can see that the wheel wells, which I'll cover in a little bit, but you can get these a little bit wider. I end up using these for the main form of these fender flares, okay? And you can kind of move that, and I'm moving them in position perspective, so a little bit of cleanup has to happen once I get that here. So you can see I just have to kind of move things and adjust things. So just making sure you're always kind of bouncing back between all of these different views here. is what you really want to do. Don't just be working in one of these views. And then for this rear portion, same thing. I can just kind of move this. So this is the power of just having good reference. I didn't shoot any of this reference. I just went ahead and just found these online and made sure that this was something that, you know, I'm a big fan of this car and just something I've been wanting to model for a good while now. So now's the perfect time to do it. So and I can kind of bring this down like so. And we can just kind of adjust the curvature there. All right, but that's essentially what I did. A lot of vertex manipulation. Lattice, which is also called FFD in 3ds Max, just freeform deformer. And then, you know, there you go. You now have a much better looking shape than what was done previously, which was this here. So again, I'm definitely a fan of this technique and using reference and photography to get the actual form of the vehicle and camera matching and getting that. This is a technique that is used in VFX industry, in games. It doesn't matter, right? Because what industry? It's just a good old CGI technique for modeling from reference imagery. Okay, so now that I've done that and focused on these large scale changes, I can move on to the next part, which is going to be adding in that hood scoop detail. So what I'm going to do now is just hide this demo piece here, and I can just kind of use what I've been demoing with so far, is I want to go ahead now and just kind of cut in that detail. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and cut in this detail for this hood scoop. All right. So what I want to do is go ahead and just select these edges. You can see I can still kind of use some of these just as a main guide, but I'm going to just scale that in the x-axis to make that nice and straight. And then from here, I can go ahead and now and start cutting in this detail with multi-cut. All right, so I'm going to go ahead now and hold shift right click. I'm going to grab my multi-cut tool here, and it doesn't is you can kind of see this on the front view, and you can probably or top view, sorry. And if I go ahead and grab my pure ref, you can see that hood scoop detail. This is what I'm trying to achieve. So this hard line on the top of this hood scoop, and then it softens towards the bottom, but we have this crease that's running along the side. So I'm going to block in that main detail. And I've always got my reference open right here on my other monitor as I'm working. And that's going to be really, really helpful. You can see that's pretty much the deal on all of these. And that crease eventually just goes back up until this hood cowl right here. And you can see there's actually this line. It was kind of hard to see in some of the reference imagery, but there's this line, essentially the hood, right, of the vehicle here, that's going to lift up. So it doesn't go all the way to the end like a typical modern vehicle. It kind of curves around. So we're going to just, you know, keep that in mind as we're modeling this feature. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and just really just kind of cut in this here. And I can actually just move this vertice. You can kind of see I'm going to have to start from here, and I'm just middle mouse dragging with the edge slide here, and this is good. And what I'll do now is multi-cut, shift right click, and I'm going to just cut in that detail here. And what I'm going to do is just route this edge. Okay, so now we're getting into this topology technique that I've covered in a lot of my other videos here. And you can see here, this is kind of what I'm going for. And I wanted to bring this in, and we're going to just edge sliding here. Now, if edge slide is a little bit finicky, another one that I like to use is this transform constraint is surface slide. Now I can slide this all along the surface without having to worry about that, you know, going in or out like it would typically if we're just moving with world transforms. So that's really, really helpful. I use this quite a bit. So I'm going to just kind of bring that in just like so, and that'll work just fine. And then now I can go ahead and just kind of continue to multi-cut all the way up the vehicle here, all the way up the hood. And I'm just going to take this to right about here. Okay. And then what I want to do is just use these edges and just kind of scale these along in this axis and just move these out. All right. And in using this front view this as a guide. You can also, of course, you know, use this perspective camera match view as well, but we have to make some adjustments here as well on this bottom piece. Okay, so there are a couple different things that we can do to get that detail for this to come out. So once we have that, you know, you can now go here, because I don't want to do this where, you know, if I tab, you can hold tab and left click all the way down, which is nice. It's just quick, like spray paint drag technique here. I don't want to pull this up. Oops, let me turn off transform constraint. I don't want to do this. Okay, that's not quite the effect that I want to go for. I want to extrude up from this detail here on the hood. Okay, and what I'll do actually is I'm going to just remember what I said about it just kind of coming about this far up based off of our reference. Okay, so I'm going to extrude up and I'll show you how to clean that up here. So what I'm going to do is shift right click and go to extrude face. And then now I'm going to extrude that up, and then I'm going to give this a little bit of an offset like so. So now this is our hood scoop detail. Okay, and you can kind of see what we have here so far, and it's aligning pretty well with what we have in our front view, and it's aligning pretty well. I have to make some adjustments here on our camera match reference, but this is the overall technique that I use. So then once I have this, I can go ahead now and make these adjustments. And what I want to do is, again, you'll notice in the reference, it starts here at its thickest and tapers in towards the end, which is what we want here. So what I want to do is grab this edge here and edge slide this down. Okay, so I'm edge sliding that down closer to the part of the vehicle as we're making our way around. And this is going to give us that nice detail that we're looking for. And then I can grab, you know, these vertices here, and I can jump to perspective. And you can see as it's going to start to narrow in a little bit more. Okay, so something like this. All right, so then now we're left with kind of this. It looks pretty good, but you have this problem now where you're like, okay, well, this is okay, but this is straight extrusion. That's not what this looks like on the vehicle. Okay, that's not what this looks like as it's tapering down. So what I did for this was I just used this to take extrusions and merge them back into the original form. I'm just going to straight delete this extruded edge here that came out. So control backspace, and then there you go. And that just is going to give us this triangle here, which isn't the worst thing in the world. But then now we can use this triangle. And what I'm going to do is start from here, and I'm going to just cut around. Okay, and this is going to give us that nice holding form, that nice holding edge that I can cut all the way around the vehicle like so. All right, and there you go. Now, keep in mind, it's not a super, super tight edge here. And for now, what I'm going to do is take this, is control backspace, and we're just going to move this. Control shift slide, middle mouse, control shift middle mouse to slide that. And then there you go. Now you're left with this kite quad, which is a great way to control topology. And then you get this, which is what I use all the time to get that effect as it's coming back towards the original form of the geometry. And then I can clean that up a bit. I can start to bring in that taper, that effect. And you can see what's going on there. And then there you go. And then that works out really, really well. And you can see that it's kind of starting to, you know, we have that main form, that main detail blocked in. And that's how I ended up adding in this hood scoop detail. And you can see that, you know, we of course just want to make sure just to, you know, match it along our reference a little bit closer. But all in all, this is giving us the nice detail that we need. All right. And I can bring those down just so they're a little bit straighter across. And then what you can do now is we have that crease that comes along, right? So now this is really, you know, rounded out here. But if you look here again, there's this more of this crease shape. Let's see if I can get a better angle here. You can kind of see that it comes to more of a point here, and we have that holding line that's pretty obvious running all the way down here. So we want to add that to our geometry. So I shift right click multi-cut, and then now I'm going to add this and just left click. Now make sure you don't have edge flow on. If you do, it's going to try to think and add in geometry where you don't want it. It actually does a good job there, but I just leave that off for now. And what I want to do is then just kind of control shift and scale. And we're going to just scale this in so it's nice and equidistant here. And it's going to give us this nice holding line and that nice crease. And there you go. Look at that. This is looking really good, right? So this nice effect here that we're using for this topology. And then, you know, as you, you know, get towards the bottom, it may spread out a little bit, and but we have that topology to control it as needed. Okay, so that works and that looks great. And that is how I ended up adding in this hood scoop detail, right? So if I grab my original one and we take a look here, you can see that's exactly what I did. Okay, so you can see that extra detail that's been added. And I've used this kite quad here, just like so. And man, these kite quads that will terminate these three edges. So we're going from 1, 2, 3. All right, and then we kite quad this here, and then you're just left with this one edge. And it just brings that surface detail back into the geometry, and that's exactly what we want. All right, so that's how I did that, which I would say is probably the most complicated part. It's not even that complicated, but then what I did was I went ahead and just added in some more geometry. You can see that things start to get a little bit spaced out. And the thing with vehicle modeling is you always want this nice even distribution of edges. So if I go ahead and actually move this back a little bit here, I can go ahead now and multi-cut and add in this edge that's going to help subdivide throughout our model here, okay? And then what I ended up doing is I went ahead and covered the next detail, which was the headlights, okay? So if I go ahead and hide this, what I'm going to do now is quickly just cover that and the detail through a narrated time lapse. So for the sake of time, and I'll go ahead and pull that up here real quick. Okay, so here I am finishing up that hood scoop detail in this time lapse, and then I'm going to move on to the headlight. And what I simply did here is move the geometry, the existing geometry, space out the edges, the faces, so I have a good even distribution. And then I do an extrude, but only as an offset. Then I use edge slide, surface slide to get the shape of the headlight. And I'm just moving and manipulating those vertices. And I'm not worried too much about, you know, the smoothness of the geometry or anything like that. All that is going to be cleaned up once I start separating and extracting panels. But right now I have what I need. And then I go ahead and just continue to refine that detail. And I go back and forth here. I do some bevels. I get a good idea of what the shape is going to look like. And I make some adjustments and going, you know, back and forth from there, because I don't want to manipulate the geometry too much once I have that bevel in. And it's just a small bevel with two segments. And so then what I do is break off the geometry and I extrude those edges back. I extrude those edges back and get that form. And then now I can see what further detail I have to do to make those adjustments. And you'll see me bouncing around. I kind of just jump to the fender area for a quick second, and then I'll make my way back to the headlight here in just a second. Okay. So I bring in a cylinder, and the cylinder is based off of the reference, and I get that in position based off of the camera match. And then now that I have that cylinder that's perfectly circular, I can now start adjusting the geometry around it because it's a perfect circle, all right? And you can see I'm bringing over that reference, letting you know I'm always looking at this reference as I'm working, and then I'm gonna make that adjustment. And this is going to help further refine and allow me to add some good shape and detail to our vehicle, all right? So I'm just going back and forth, making those adjustments. And you can see I just have a couple simple holding lines there and working in smooth preview here as well, because I want to make sure that it's nice and curved and rounded as I'm going. All right. And then I just make sure to re-symmetry the vehicle over. Now I did jump over to the wheel well here, and I re-symmetry that over. So, and there you go. That's essentially the main detail that I did for the headlight. And once I have that adjusted, I go ahead now and start working on that front detail, the front fascia. And now I want to just kind of cut in an edge to better support those edges. And I'm going to add in another edge to better support the geometry. And you can see I add one more here for that wheel well. So I'm just kind of going back and forth there. And you can see I am kind of pulling that edge up that is kind of stretching. And what I end up doing is, you know, that's why I ended up cutting that one towards the bottom. And what I'm going to do now is run an edge to help that body line all the way across. And then that's going to run across the headlight as well. So that's what I'm doing here. You can see that edge, that newly added edge that I added there, that's going to help hold that form. And then since I did that, I just quickly redid the headlight shell there. And that'll work, and then I can just make some further adjustments. But I'm pretty happy, I'm really happy with how that's starting to look so far. All right, so what I'm gonna show here is how I quickly did the fender flares. All I did was just select those faces, duplicate and extract, and then I extrude inwards actually. So you'll see me making some adjustments there. I extrude inwards and then I just add in a few holding lines, and you'll notice tapers on the edge, okay? And I make sure to add that form in there. And then what I do is I go ahead and just extrude in that edge, that lip that's connected to the vehicle. So it makes it look like it's two surfaces being combined with each other. This was really, really simple, really straightforward. And once I do that, I just make some adjustments to the edges and then quickly move on. All right, so this video, this part of the time lapse just covers the air splitter and the air dam. And this is very, very, you know, very simple, straightforward, just box modeling. It's a very simple shape, and I'm just moving and adjusting the overall form and shape here, as you can see. And I'm making sure to look at the perspective match, because the reference imagery isn't going to help me too much. I mean, I can get the overall shape of it from that. For the side views, the orthographic views, I really need to make sure that I'm looking at the reference imagery for this one. So you'll see me doing that more and more over the course of this series, and as we break off of the reference, the blueprints. Then I planar model the air dam underneath the air splitter, and I'm just using edge copy. So I'm grabbing edges and moving, and you can see I just did a nice simple cut for that corner. And I cover that technique and how to model corners in 3D modeling, hard surface modeling. So I can kind of show that again here in this series, because I'm going to be using that over and over. And I just start to go around, and once I get that overall topology, I go ahead and just start copying, edge copying, which is just selecting edges with move, holding shift, and moving. Okay. And then I make some adjustments. I noticed that the side of the vehicle needed to be brought down a little bit. And I'm just making some more adjustments as I see fit. You'll see me jumping around here and there over the course of the series, or over the course of the modeling. And I noticed that there was an angle on the air dam, so I'm trying to mimic that here. So I'm bringing it down towards an angle, and you can see I'm just using very simple edge flow, very simple topology here, and I'm focusing first on the form. Then I go ahead and start adding thickness and refine, which is my mantra for modeling, is just keep it simple and only add form as you need, and then just continue to refine and go forward, only adding geometry as you need it. And then now that I got both of those pieces in, you can see I'll go ahead and add in that crease, that holding line down the middle to get that sharp edge. And then I go ahead and add in some more holding lines just to get this initial form blocked in. I'm definitely going to have to come back, add in more detail, but I'm still focusing on just adding in key features, key forms, and then I'll come back and then add in more detail. Okay, so here I am back in real time in Maya, and here is where we ended up after all the time lapses in the videos. Now remember, I'm just focusing on the key features and details of the vehicle. This is by no means done. There's some cleanup that I still have to do here for easing this artifacting here, which I'll make sure to cover in further detail. Once you start separating panels and start doing the paneling, that's where all of that artifacting is going to be easing, okay? Now you can see there's some good shape coming in here. We're getting these nice body lines, all with this nice simple geometry. We're getting this nice key detail. So I really wanted to emphasize this, which is this nice body line that's running all the way across the vehicle. And then it kind of comes in with these two edges, and then it runs across the headlight and then across the front fascia. You see that over and over again in these references where you have these body lines, this nice surface body line coming in and then creases down across. Okay. And you'll see that over and over again in these body panels, okay? And then once, you know, we separate, we have more control over where we can end and start creases and whatnot, which I'll be sure to cover, okay? It is just an iterative process. We are going to continue to add detail, but I don't just jump into separating panels out, adding in the doors and adding in every single crease line. When you do that, it just causes all sorts of problems. And as you can see down here for the air dam, I didn't get caught up in adding in all of these cuts yet. I'm definitely going to do that. And first I need to figure out what type of air dam that I want, but I know I'm going to be adding in a lot more detail into those for sure, which is going to be coming. So I hope, you know, this format was helpful. I do a combination of real time and I show you guys how I do things high level through time lapses, all so I can try to fit this in with about, you know, 30 to 35 minutes per video. I try not to go too long or too over that. So let me know if you found that helpful. And then last thing is right here. This is what I meant by making sure that these look like two panels coming in and joining like so. Okay, so that's what I mean. I don't just cut and it looks like it was just a die cut perfectly. This I'm trying to mimic real life, which is multiple panels being bolted together. So all of that is going to be coming through on our model. And you can see that overlap happening here with this geometry. Okay, now I don't have backface culling on this. But again, I hope this format, you enjoyed it. And if you're interested, let me know down below if you want the real-time captures. I do have those, but I'm trying to think about a good way to get those to people if they're interested or if you just like this format. But anyways, let's go ahead and end it here. I'm really looking forward to the next few videos as well as we continue to refine and add detail. So the next part is going to start working our way, you know, from the front and then towards the back. You know, I might add windows as well as work my way to the rear of the vehicle. So we'll see how far we can get in the next part. Might be another couple of videos. So with that, thank you for watching. If you stuck around this far, always appreciated. Like and subscribe. So thank you, everyone. Take care, and I'll see you around.